ahead and use for the very first time the Morphe 9J palette. It comes with 9 shades, themes purples and pinks. I went ahead and decided to go ahead and review this palette and also make a look out of it. I decided to do an easy cut crease using the shadows in this palette. I really hope you guys enjoy watching this video, but before we get into it, make sure you're subscribed. Make sure you also give me a thumbs up and leave a comment below of what you guys think. Thank you so much for watching, and let's get straight into it. Okay, so this is the packaging for the Morphe 9J Just a Crush on You palette. The theme of the palette are pinks and purples. You get 9 shades. The palette was really sleek. The only thing I hate about new packages, anything that comes with like very sleek packaging, is like your fingerprints. I don't know about you guys, but the moment I put like my fingerprints or I have something on my fingers and I touch anything sleek, nice, it automatically just goes to shame. But anyways, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys the swatches from the palette. The first shade is Will They, which is a matte peach as described online. The second shade is Wink, which is a shimmering rosy copper. The third shade is Butterflies, which is a shimmering icy rose. The fourth shade is Glance, it's a shimmering champagne. The fifth shade is First, which is a matte fuchsia with an undertone of pink. The sixth shade is Double Text, which is considered to be a matted sangria. The seventh shade is Casually, which is a matte chocolate. The eighth shade is Flustered, which is a shimmering plum. And last but not least, the last shade is Make a Move, which is a matte eggplant. So I went ahead and used the shade First to begin with the look. I didn't know how the pigment was going to be with the look, so I started off very lightly. I started with the outer corner and made sure to blend my way with sweeping motions to the inner corner, and I continued to repeat this step until I was satisfied with how it looked on the eye. Throughout this video, you're actually gonna see me turn my head over quite a few times. I was in the middle of watching one of my new shows on Netflix, which is called Greenleaf. If you guys haven't watched it, I would definitely suggest you guys add it to your list of things to watch during quarantine. It's so addicting. But yeah, I just wanted to go ahead and pop up in here to let you guys know that I am definitely focused not only on my look, but I'm also focused on my show.
beginning of this look, I used a more fluffier, less dense brush, and I went ahead and switched over to a brush that I could pack the shadow on more with. It makes a difference when you're using a fluffier brush and a more dense brush. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this dense brush to actually pack on the color so you can actually see the color in the pigment. And I'm gonna continue to do that on both sides. Go ahead and begin the process of cutting my crease. It's definitely different for everyone depending on your eye shape, of how you create your cut crease. I know there's definitely different ways and different techniques that you can use to do your cut crease, so I'm just gonna let you guys watch how I do mine. The only tip that I can give you guys when it comes to making a good cut crease is finding yourself a good flat dense brush, just because it'll actually give you the precision that you're looking for. If you went ahead and decided to use a light flimsy brush, you're not gonna get that precise line that you're trying to create when making a cut crease. So yeah, I'm gonna let you guys see how I do it, and I'll come back when we are ready for the next step. So I'm just gonna clean this up as much as I possibly can without getting frustrated. I just wanted to come in here and remind you guys that everyone's eyes are different, everyone's cut creases are different. You can make it as low, as high as you'd like it. I know with me and me having hooded eyes, I'm expected to cut my crease a little bit up more than your average person. But I don't know, it just depends. I liked how where I landed my cut crease on this look, so I just left it at that. But you guys can definitely cut your crease however high or low as you like it. You can also make it more round, you can make it less round. It honestly just depends on how you want it to look and if you like it or not. Another tip when it comes to making your cut creases, I would definitely suggest blending it out with some type of sponge before you go in with the shadow on top, if you are even going in with the shadow on top, just because it might get a little bit gunky on you if you went ahead and just put an eyeshadow right on top of the wet stickiness of your concealer or your base. So I would definitely make sure that you use a blender or some type of beauty sponge to soak up all that extra product that doesn't need to be on your lids, and then go in with your shadow on top. So I'm beginning to pack on the shade Butterflies. It's the shimmery, icy pink shade in the palette. When it came to the shadow, I didn't have any trouble at all. It packed on nicely. It glided on smoothly as well. I didn't have any patchiness or grittiness when it came to packing it onto my lid, so I was very impressed with that. The only thing I am going to say when it came to the shadow was there was some fallout, but that's expected when you're using any type of glittery eyeshadow. You're expected to have fallout, so it wasn't an issue for me, but I just wanted to give you guys a heads up. So I decided to deepen up my look a little bit. I'm using the matte purple shade in the palette, which is Make a Move. I'm using that with the fluffy brush. All the brushes that I used in this video, I'll definitely make sure to leave in the description box below. But yeah, I'm just using this brush along with the shadow to deepen up the look a little bit and give me a little bit more definition on the outer corner of my eyes. So I just wanted to come in here and let you guys know that there's definitely kickback with this palette. I'm only letting you guys know just because I know it might be a deal breaker for some. With me personally, I don't have a problem with any of my palettes having kickback or fallout. As long as it works properly, then I'm totally fine with it. But I'm definitely getting quite a few kickback as I'm dipping my brush into the pans with the shadows. But I definitely want to point out, on the other hand, that these shadows are working great. They're performing great. When it comes to packing them on, I'm not having any problem. I'm not having any issues with blending or anything like that. They're all meshing very nicely. So I definitely just want to let you guys know that when it comes to the performance of the shadows, I definitely would give it a 10 out of 10. Let me not say 10 out of 10, but I mean, you guys know what I mean. Like, I'm not having any trouble with it. Do I think that the palette is worth it for its price? Definitely, I would say yes. Go for it. Do I think the colors work great? Yes. I'm not having any fading when it comes to the shadows. I'm not having any type of patchiness when it comes to the shadows. So yes, I would definitely suggest that you go out there yourself and check out the palette for yourself and see how it works for you. So off camera, I went ahead and did my lashes and began my face. I'm now finishing my under eyes. I'm using the fuchsia pink shade first, and I'm using that under my eyes, and I'm keeping it very close knit, very tight under my waterline. I'm not gonna go ahead and smoke it out or blend it down any further than what you guys see here. You are gonna see me use a fluffier brush further on in the video, but it's only just so I can blend out the harsh lines and not keep it so stark under my eyes. Thank you.
guys enjoyed watching this. I really had fun creating the look and doing the cut crease. Hopefully you learned some tips and tricks. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.